And you can see the starting lineups brought to you by Taco Bell across the top of your screen. Robert Thomas floats one in on Jari, and he'll glove it down on the power play as well, and their big guns are not scoring. The other way comes Malkin, a two-on-one with Rust to his right. Malkin moves in, toe drag, shoots, and Binnington makes the save. The rebound loose, and Binnington got a piece again. Kyrou back the other way.
Because of an icing call, gets a great opportunity here, a two-on-one chance. But watch the stick of Marco Scandella right here. He kind of slows down that shot, allows Binnington to get that.
A battle along the half wall as Zucker looks to reverse. Gave it away. Logan Thomas flips it into Jari's chest protector, and it ends up just to his left. Off the draw, Ruda with a drive that just goes wide. Falk lost it. A wraparound shot by Zucker was put on net. He tries again, and he hits the iron. Doubt Jordan Binnington to keep the game scoreless.
Yeah, no doubt, right? It's not really a face-off win. I think it's Falk that ends up turning that puck over to the Ruda to the point, and then the chance by Jason Zucker as the second chance here right off the post. But Zucker was, to me, a young player like that probably shouldn't be saying what he said.
Binnington with a save on the doorstep. Another good look for Zucker. Pull out and disrupt that toe drag shot. Bluger floats one towards the net, flipping it high and wide, and just missing again was Archibald. A defensive breakdown that time for the Blues. Throwing one out in front. Bluger looking for
chance for Bluger, but after that defensive play, Archibald left all alone in front of the net.
Poked at by Raquel. Back to the point. Letang sweeps one diagonally into the corner. Chopped at by Raquel. Gensel has it. Centers one. Crosby gets it on net. A rebound. Loose. Binnington made the save in traffic. As he got a loud cheer after those last couple of saves.
Yeah, he's been sharp this afternoon, and he was sharp in that loss against Vancouver. He's gotten off to a great start.
Drew O'Connor with speed. Backhander. Save Binnington. And he's able to guide the puck wide with his glove hand.
So they did a lot of positive things. Unfortunately, not able to get that first goal. A little bit left to go on this penalty kill and see if they can get back at it 5-on-5.
Zucker out of the box. The double minor is now officially killed off by the Penguins. And we are back at 5-a-side. Thomas does a lap in the offensive zone. Floats one on net. Score! Knocked out of midair! And the Blues are able off the deflection to get on the board first at 5-on-5 as Buchnevich got his stick on the puck.
It's a smart play by Thomas here. You know, you just get it to the net, and how often do you hear it? Get it to the net, good things can happen. The question will be is that stick below the crossbar? It looked initially to me like it was. I'm sure they're going to take a look at it, but for Jari, that's a tough one. I mean, you're anticipating the puck coming up around your throat. Buchnevich gets a stick on it. Maybe not for players, but for certainly us broadcasters and fans, it's a fun time.
Letty with speed through center. Brings it across the Penguins' line. Letty towards the net. Buchnevich put it in on Jari softly.
Against the Pittsburgh Penguins and some stars like Crosby and Malkin and Letang.
And here is Malkin across the line. Rust to his right. Back to Malkin. Score! Beautiful give and go. Malkin and Rust. And finally, the pressure pays off for the Penguins. They're on the board.
On their toes. Wish they got one or two goals. And most people would have thought that Rust here after the feed from Malkin would have just ripped this puck on net. But tremendous vision and patience to get this puck under Scandella.
And then returned as Tarasenko was sent by St. Louis to Manhattan. Heinen puts it on net. Oh, it hit the post. Bluger with a great opportunity right between the circles. We're jousting for it. Now Barbashev escapes. Racing after it, Thomas, right in front, Barbashev, puts it on net, save made by Jari, the rebound loose, and it's gathered in now by Raquel, hops out for the Penguins, and Jari kills some time in the trapezoid, and now on the forecheck, Saad creates some havoc, takes the puck away, shorthanded, centers one, Barbashev, on net, and Jari was able to stick the blocker out and make the save. He looks for a long outlet pass at Karams off of Toropchenko, who hits Letang and takes the puck away. Here is Buchnevich to Toropchenko. Shoot! Save made by Jari! And Letang has the rebound. Tied at one for two teams that in their last four games combined, Don't have a win to speak of. 0-4, the last four for Pittsburgh. That shot in on Binnington, blocked in front. Arums right to Crosby. Shot pass down low, Gensel. Spread eagle with the left pad, Binnington, as he closed the door. And the Blues clear. Binnington Bush continues to do work.
Yeah, he certainly does. Pittsburgh 0-2 on the power play. You see right here, he's outstretched, gets his arm on that one from Gensel, and Crosby, who did a good job halfway through that power play with his own entry and eventually led to this right here as he gets it down to Gensel. Watch Crosby right here. I thought he was trying.
Gains the St. Louis zone. Zucker with a toe drag. In behind the net. Backhands one. Up top, a return to Rust. Rust to Zucker. Shot. Save made. The rebound. And somewhere it gets lost in Binnington's equipment. I think he's got it in the glove. And there is Barbashev working the wall once again. This time Teddy Bluger takes it away. Around to Petrie. Softly up the boards. An outlet. Drew O'Connor finds Bluger. The drop pass. Pettersson shoots. Scores! Marcus Pettersson jumps into the play. The defenseman with a huge goal for the Penguins to give them the 2-1 lead. Under 5.5 to go.
Here's St. Louis. They've got numbers. It's 3-on-3, but it's a good job by Bluger to carry this puck and push the Blues defense back. And when you do that, it allows Pettersson, who jumps into the play, to have time and space.
Rust able to escape to Malkin. Malkin, center circle, across the line, wrist shot, hit the post. It's in behind Binnington as Malkin ends up knocked to the ice by Falk. And we'll start to keep our eyes on Binnington and see when he may head to the bench. Sammy Blay gains the zone. Blay moves in. Blay in front. Poked off his stick. It's loose under bodies. A mosh pit in front of Jari. He's looking for the puck. No whistle. Is it in? They score! 2:27 to go. And somewhere in all that traffic, the puck ends up behind Tristan Jari. Oh.
Oh my goodness, I mean, I don't even know where the puck is there. That'd be a great question for Jax. I mean, you lose sight of the puck. I can't see it. As a goaltender, you just hope for a whistle here. I mean, I would think it's tied up there somehow. It's loose.
Plays over. So you let it roll. If you're pretty sure that puck's loose, we can reverse it after the fact. Great positioning by Dan O'Rourke.
Well, as a goalie, I don't like it. Blow the whistle.
Well, they let it roll. We will roll to overtime.
You're confident that you can create a really good chance before giving up possession of that puck. Pittsburgh not able to hang on to the lead, but they don't care if St. Louis got a point or not. What matters right now is if they can get the extra one here in the overtime.
Rust gains some speed. Rust across the line. Rust, wrist shot blocked by Krug. Corralled by Malkin to Rust. Score! Earlier in the game, it was Rust to Malkin. In overtime, they reverse it. And the Penguins get both of the points on the road you know they were desperate for.
Rust, a terrific entry right here. The initial shot is blocked, but who came up with the loose change? Evgeny Malkin. If he doesn't come up with that puck, it could go the other way. Again, puck possession is important. Malkin regains it. He got the feed from Rust earlier in the game. This time, he returns the favor.